when I was a student, I didn't understand what course evaluations were, or if they were even important. They were just something we did every year, and frankly, I didn't always fill them out. And I certainly didn't think carefully about what I said there. I realize now that was probably a mistake. Now that I'm faculty, I have a much more complicated relationship with course evaluations, like most people who teach in academia. When I was at my previous institution in 2016, I was told that no way, no how could I get tenure there unless I got above a certain average evaluation in a particular course taught in this building here. And I only found out about this after signing up for this new course taught for the very first time by me or by anybody else. And then I got my request for a teaching assistant for this 100-person course denied by the department the month before the course started. Other faculty in my area were teaching 20-person classes or 40-person classes with a TA. Not that I'm bitter. The only advice I got was make the class harder so that kids would drop out and you won't have to teach so many. I was a wreck. My whole career depended on pleasing 100 sophomores and juniors while ostensibly teaching them how to run a regression. And 2 weeks into the class, I found out that they didn't really learn Python in a previous class, and the sole grader I had for the course didn't touch any of the assignments. Oh, and I was told that there were complaints that the class was too hard. Surprise. The only way I kept my sanity was by telling myself that I'd focus on teaching the class I wanted to teach and that whatever would happen with the evaluations would happen. I had a newborn baby at home and a wife who had also lost her job, so what did it matter if I got kicked out of my job? Long story short, I eventually got tenure and moved to another university. If I had my druthers, we'd do away with evaluations like this completely. Teaching evaluations are skewed by who responds, are biased against particular groups, and don't reward competence. So you shouldn't be using a flawed system that systematically disadvantages specific groups to make big decisions like giving someone a job in 2016. But hey, I hear you say you have tenure now. You don't need to worry about course evaluations anymore. Ah, but I do. They are reflected in things like merit pay raises, and more importantly, if I get to teach the classes that I want to teach. Particularly for courses that are in high demand, if your evaluations stink, you won't get to teach them. And I really like teaching the courses that I teach. That's why I teach them. And I want to keep teaching them, so I need to keep the high rating. So if you like the class, please rate it, and rate it well. Don't blow off the course evaluations, and if there are things that you don't like about the course, tell me about them now. If I can fix them now, it doesn't help you if you wait until the course evaluation to let me know about them. Now, there are some things that you might not like that I do intentionally, and I'm not going to change those, but there are things that you don't like that are making your life hard that I might not know about and I could easily fix. Thus, let me know about them now, and there are anonymous ways of letting me know about that. For example, Piazza comments. If you wait until the course evaluations, then you don't get the benefit from your feedback. Only the next course does, if it happens. So there's lots of stuff that you can and should tell me. And if you just need to vent, I'm happy to listen too, and I'd rather you vent on Piazza than on a course evaluation. And don't just talk about the things that you don't like. Talk about the things that you did like, particularly if they're uncommon in classes. For instance, in 2021, I offered a course in person and online, hybrid options. I didn't have to do that. It was a lot of work, and plenty of people took advantage of it. But nobody, not a single person, mentioned that in the evaluations. And I got much lower scores than my entirely in-person offering with almost the exact same course content. If I didn't feel ethically obligated to provide a hybrid course option given the epidemiological situation, from my perspective, the incentive is clear: no hybrid option. And if the expensive, cumbersome parts of the course don't get positive feedback, then the department can easily tell me that I shouldn't do them anymore. And I know that some things are suboptimal, I can't change them, I'm sorry, but these sorts of things are actually worth it from my perspective for you to complain about because my bosses read the course evaluations. Do we not have enough GPUs available for students to use? Say that. Are there too few TEAs? Say that, particularly if you're using a time machine to watch this in 2016. Should DIT not ban students from using Google Cloud credits? Say that. Is the room layout not a good fit for in-classroom interactions? Say that. Does a computer on the third floor of CSIC drive you as crazy as it drives me? Say that. These are things that I have no control over, and if students keep complaining about them, there is a probability, a small one but non-zero, that these things will eventually get fixed. Just as I've learned that grades are a tool that we should use but not overemphasize, I've come to feel the same way about course evaluations. And just as how I wish I could give an Uber driver something other than a 5-star rating if something wasn't just right to convey some information, we don't live in that world. I wish we had better systems, but it is what it is. Rather than closing our eyes and hoping for the best, which was my strategy in fall 2016, I'd like to have an honest and frank conversation about how we, both you as a student and me as a professor, can use the tools we have to make this class as good as it can be. So if you have questions or want to talk about course evaluations, please feel free to ask those questions, again, anonymously if you want. Because I really like this class and because I want to be able to teaching it, please, one, fill out the course evaluations if you like the class, two, talk about the things that you like, not just the things you didn't, and three, tell me now if there are things that we could do better. Thanks for listening to this meta discussion, and we'll use some of our in-class discussion to talk about how to improve this course going forward. And if you're uncomfortable saying it then, please do send an anonymous message. I don't like course evaluations. They stress me out, and it makes teaching even more transactional than it should. So if you're ever in a position of power, please do your part to make course evaluations a thing of the past, and if nothing else, less of a scary tool. But until then, thanks for listening to the story of my complicated relationship with course evaluations. This is just a single lecture from a course. YouTube likes to show you these videos out of order, but if you go to the course webpage linked below, you can see the lectures in the right order, and you can get resources like homeworks or suggested reading. You can also visit quanta.org if you want to learn about our systems for creating computers that can answer questions, where Quanta stands for question answering is not a trivial activity. If you want to help the channel, provide a big gradient to the algorithm by liking and subscribing.